Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff sculpts the eyelids and shows how to manage several sculpts using the Sculpt History panel.
Alright, next we can do the eyelids. There's some sculpting you can do there, and oftentimes you don't really need to do much because you can get quite a lot of control out of the edge curves, but I'll show you the process just in case. So let's say this is kind of your closed extreme. Same process, you just hit eyelid sculpting this time. And there's your mesh. So tweak mode and just start pulling vertex around. I'm in symmetry here, so I get both sides at once. So you might want to, you know, adjust little things that you couldn't quite get tweaked out with the curves. Okay, let's just say that's what we wanted to do. And apply. And that's where they end up now if you move the controllers. So same thing for the lower lids. And you can actually do multiple sculpts if you want. You can do a sculpt at the halfway point and kind of work your way through a few sculpts on the way down. And each sculpt is tied to a controller position, so that's how it knows when it's 100%. It's going right back to that position again. And one thing to notice is if you go into the Tools panel, you have a Sculpt History. So I should have a couple of these now. And one of them was the corrugators that we did, and one is the eyelid. And it gives you a type, so you know it's a skin or an eyelid sculpt. And you can also name these. And so this one was, the first one we did was the corrugators. Let's just say angry brow. And upper lids closed. Whoops. So you can kind of manage them that way, and you can also do things like apply pose, and it puts it right back into the state that it was when you made that sculpt, so you can always get it back to the exact same position that sculpt is working towards. Same thing for the eyelids, apply pose there. You can delete these and start over. You can see the points that are being affected by the sculpts. So you have a little bit of information there you can use later. You can mute them as well and get kind of before and after. So I can kind of see the difference there that the sculpt's making. So lots of good control there.